Meanwhile, a medical revolution is underway when it comes to screening for cancer, and artificial intelligence is at the center of all of it. Here to explain is Fox News senior medical analyst Dr. Marc Siegel. His new book is called The Miracles Among Us, How God's Grace Plays a Role in Healing, and it is a beautiful book filled with beautiful stories. We'll get to that in just a moment. Meanwhile, this new artificial intelligence mammogram technology, this could be game-changing in the medical world. Why?
Because as you just pointed out, over 50% of women, especially younger women, have dense breasts. And when you have dense breasts, it's very hard via a mammogram to figure out if there's actually a problem or not. Mammograms don't do well reading through that the density. So then you do an ultrasound. So you're doing two tests now, and women are getting afraid. What are you doing? Why another test? Why are you calling me back? And then, even then, they may not be able to give you an answer. They'll say, I'll repeat it in 6 months. And then you're even more afraid. You're worrying for 6 months. What does AI add to that picture? Here's what it adds. It adds an ability to use machine learning to compare it to a whole database and say, thousands of other women had that exact same problem and it didn't turn out to be anything. Mm. You have a calcification, but we're not worried about this particular kind of calcification. Mm. We see a few clusters, but that's not the kind we worry about. AI can inform the radiologist, who can then have an additional tool. Of course, it's still the radiologist that's got to learn how to speak to the patient or the primary care doctor or the gynecologist so that women don't get unnecessarily afraid. But you asked me a question before I came on here about unnecessary biopsies, which is a huge problem, but this tool should decrease your need for biopsies.
That would be good news, because what's happening is some of the mammogram results and the ultrasound results cause some, as I have read, you tell me, confusion in the medical world, and it sends that person in for additional screening. The experts, this is how the AI software works, you tell me. This works by feeding it hundreds of thousands of sometimes millions of mammogram images. This is the AI software, okay? Some of the images contain cancerous tumors, and over time, the AI learns to distinguish the often subtle differences between malignant and benign tissue. Some AI programs, like the one used on Hall, identify a suspicious area. This was a particular patient in the NBC News article. Others predict the chance that a woman will develop breast cancer.
This is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, so we're focusing on this, but this is also true in other parts of the body. There's a kind of technology called Sybil that does this with the lung. If you're a smoker, it says, that part of the lung worries us, it's not cancer, keep an eye on that part of the lung. There's also something called opportunistic screening, where literally, and we're doing this at NYU Langone, this research right now, where literally, they're looking for one thing, and they say, by the way, over here, we see something else. So that's AI. That's artificial intelligence. Also, artificial intelligence gives you targets to look for treatments, say, for cancer treatments. There's an abnormal protein. What does that mean? Can we target it? Personalized medicine is going to be led by artificial intelligence.
Seems like this is only a tool that is going to further aid the medical community.
Very exciting.
Very good. Dr. Siegel, thank you for being here on that.
Good to see you.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.